Curry.
Thank you.
Something is not right here. Be on your guard. Behind me!
Since time beyond memory, I have been sealed away in that frozen fjord. But now I am released. Alas, my lengthy imprisonment has sorely depleted my powers. If the skies above Sniffleheim are to once more dance, first I must feast. You shall have the honor of being the auroral serpent's sabbath.
Not done yet! for the old dog yet.
You are strong, just like the detestable luminary, the one who sealed me away all those years ago. But where Erdwin succeeded, you shall succumb!
What the... You can't... move!
Piteous wretches! Prepare to be consumed!
Beast, be gone, thou black offence! May heaven's winds propel thee hence! Don't worry, everyone. I'll have you back on your feet in no time.
No way!
Bold luminary, Yggdrasil's chosen, long have I waited to greet you. We of Arborea swear to protect you. While we live, none shall defeat you. It's ever so nice to see you all again.
Serena, it's really you. Thanks for helping us out there. But where did you spring from, and where have you been?
I've been trying to make my way back to Arborea ever since that awful day. But I got rather sidetracked seeing to those who needed my help. When I heard that the golden iceberg blocking Sniffelheim Harbor had melted away, I decided to try and make my way home from there. I never thought I'd meet you on the way.
You're heading to Arborea, eh? We're on our way there ourselves. Reckoned you keepers would be the best folk to ask about a certain sacred flying contraption.
A flying contraption? Well, I've never heard of such a thing, but I'm sure Father Benedictus will know something about it. It's so wonderful to see you all again. Would you mind awfully if I tagged along with you? If we follow the path up the mountain, we'll be in Arborea in no time. Well then, shall we?
Thank you.
triumph was never in doubt.
This is awful. It was so beautiful here before.
Our poor little angels. Veronica, Serena, please come back. We'll do anything.
Fidelis, Alma, you must not lose hope. Veronica and Serena are the heirs to the power of that most holy of sages. As long as they are together, there is nothing that can...
Oh. Serena? Is it really you? Mother? Father? You're alive!
Oh, Serena, my little angel. I never thought I'd see you again.
Serena, my child... Have you come back to us alone? What of Veronica?
She's not here. But see. She's certainly somewhere nearby. I can sense it. Somewhere north of here.
You could really tell where she is.
Yes, it's her. I know it is. We have to go and find her.
Thank you.
You think Veronica's really here? If she is, she's keeping a low profile.
When we were children, Veronica and I would often come to this grove to play. I was sure she would be waiting for me here. Veronica! Veronica, where are you? Oh. Ah, there she is! I knew it! Wake up, lazy bones! You'll catch cold sleeping outside like this. Veronica? Look, her staff is shining. Do you think if you touch it, you might have one of your visions? Veronica, you gave your life to save us.
No!
Darling, even in your final moments, you were thinking of your friends.
No!
Oh, Veronica.
Why must the good die young?
Death be in vain. Where she led, I must follow. I have to tell everyone. I have to tell Mother and Father.
O great and glorious Yggdrasil, whose holy heart is this symbol of all life. Today, we mourn the loss of a beloved child of Arborea. Though she came into life with another of your hallowed leaves, she departed this realm alone.
For gathering here today to celebrate the life of my dear sister. Even in her darkest hour, Veronica thought not of herself, but only of protecting the luminary. She was a keeper to the last. Now, I ask that each of you offer up a lock of hair to the sacred flame, that its light may guide her on her way back to the World Tree.
Oh, Veronica, my little angel. Curse you, Mordiggan. Why could you not have taken me instead?
My darling, darling daughter. How could you leave us without saying goodbye?
Serena appears steadfast despite her grief. But the sight of her poor parents is heartbreaking indeed.
My child, I must speak with you and your friends. When you have a moment, please come to the cathedral. Forgive me for summoning you here at this time of sadness, but there is something I believe you will be eager to hear. You came in search of the sacred conveyance upon which Erdwin and his allies rode out to face the Dark One, did you not?
How did you know that?
Well, some days before your arrival, Holy Yggdrasil granted me another vision. I saw you, honored luminary. You were standing alongside Serena upon a great white object that transported you to an island in the sky. A strange and beautiful place.
And you think this was a vision of the future?
I do, for in my dream, I have been greatly troubled as to what her absence might mean. I had hoped and prayed that my fears were unfounded, yet, alas, they were not. Which made me wonder if the conveyance upon which you stood might also be real. And then I remembered. Cetacea. The legends tell of a divine being who soared through the skies on silver wings, a beast summoned to Erdwin's side by a mystical melody. Perhaps it was upon Cetacea's back that you rode in my vision. And perhaps the island upon which you alighted is the next step on your journey. I intend to scour the annals for indications of how she might be summoned. I will inform you forthwith if my researches should prove fruitful. Now, the day's unhappy events have surely taken their toll. Rooms have been prepared for you all at the inn. Pray, rest a while.